Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to go over this problem. You would usually find a problem like this in a statistics and probability class. It says let u be a uniform random variable, and then it gives you the PDF and the CDF. Then it asks you to consider the function or the transform y equal to u squared, and it asks you to find the probability distribution of y. So if you're asked to get a probability distribution, you can provide three answers, or you can basically solve the problem three ways. You can give the PDF of y, which would be FYY. You can give the CDF, which is capital F Y, Y, or you can give the moment generating function, which is 1-to-1 with a PDF, so that's also a unique solution. And so for this problem, I'm going to use the CDF approach to provide the probability distribution of Y. All right, so to get the CDF of Y, we're going to use what the transform is, which is what we're given. So there's a formula basically that says that the CDF of y, written like this, is equal to the probability that y is less than or equal to y. And we know that y is equal to u squared. So usually when you learn about it, you'll learn that y can be considered a function of x. So in this case, our x is u, so y is equal to u squared. So this is the same as saying u squared is less than or equal to y. And if we solve for y, this is the same as saying the probability of u is less than or equal to the square root of y. And now that we have u is less than or equal to some value, this probability is the same as the CDF of x when you have x equal to the square root of y, and in this case, our x is u. So we go from fy of y to fu of a value where you plug in y. So once you get from here to here, we already have fu of u, and now to get the CDF for f of y, all we have to do is plug in the square root of y for u in this distribution. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. So f of y is equal to 0, and again, we're going to plug in the square root of y for u, and if we square that, we still get y less than 0 for the range. For u, we're going to plug in the square root of y, and then this is going to be 1. So if we have 0 less than or equal to the square root of y less than 1, if we square that on both sides, we're still going to get 0 less than or equal to y less than 0, less than 1, excuse me. And the same thing here. So now we officially have the CDF of y. The CDF of y is a unique solution, so it's sufficient to just list the CDF of y if you have a question asking what the probability distribution of y is. But if there's a follow-up question, for example, that asks what the PDF of y is, you can also get that solution. So the PDF of y, which is written fy of y, is equal to the derivative of the CDF. So if we have that the CDF function is the square root of y, that's equal to y to the 1/2. If you take the derivative, that's y to the negative 1/2, which is equal to 1 over 2 times the square root of y. So for f of y, we have 1 over 2 times the square root of y. Y cannot be 0 because then the denominator for this fraction will be 0. So y has to be greater than 0. And we have from our CDF of y that this goes to 1, and then it's going to be 0 otherwise. And with that, we are done with this problem.